You have no idea what they can do. You think you do, but you don't.
When seeing Will and Saul mourn Jack's death, we thought it was important when something like this happens, when somebody who really matters a great deal to these guys gets taken from them abruptly and horribly without any warning, that they respond to it in a way that feels real to us. I thought that their performance, especially when they opened the box, I thought they did a beautiful job there of sinking the hook on how horrible and inexplicable it must feel to have something like this happen to you.
Hello?
Hey.
Hey. One of Jin's closest friends is probably Will. No matter what's going on in their lives, any time they're together, I think, is a really precious time.
I've rented this little cottage on the beach.
That sounds nice. No matter what storms are going on, he's like the island that she can always go to, where everything is calm and safe.
It's a decade later, and I think the line, "In nature, nothing exists alone," still resonates for Ye, who has now left Red Coast Base and is working as a professor, but she still has not met anyone else who she connects with and could possibly share this worldview that she has, except this one guy that she met once. And even after years, they're still in each other's minds.
I'm glad you remember me.
Which I believe, watching that scene and all their scenes together, because there is real chemistry between them. Like, you believe it from the first time they met in China till the reunion in the restaurant. There's something there. I mean, you just feel it.
Back on that hilltop, I did something.
In Shishin Liu's books, fairy tales play an important part. So I think we were all drawn to that aspect of the story.
Grandma, what big eyes you've got.
It's actually one of my favorite scenes of the whole season. Jonathan Pryce does such a great job. I just love him in the scene because he's not interacting with anyone. He's interacting with a voice coming over the loudspeaker.
So the story, it is a lie about a liar?
What you do as an actor is, when it's something, behavior which is so extreme, what you don't want to try and do is comment on it while you're playing it or make decisions about it while you're, but you just have to be.
We think we understand now.
See, that's why you need us.
So I just love the performance there. I love how simple it is.
And, when you talk about the things you haven't seen before, and how, especially as a science fiction series, this series gives you so many opportunities to deliver big, wild, crazy, phantasmagoric things. But one thing, to have all that happening, and then to have one of the two probably most important scenes in the show, to have that scene be something, as David just said, something so simple, and then to make the mistake that he makes.
You do this? You lie?
Well, I try not to, but we all do sometimes.
And the irony is, Evan's big mistake is he's asked if he lies, and he should have lied.
He should have said no.
We never lie.
I don't do that. No,
he had only
said
that.
Only our enemies.
Yeah, right.
Instead, he chooses poorly.
Feels like he would have played that one differently if he had to do it over again.
Yeah.
Also, with the Santee, everything you do and everything you say, they are watching, and you're not going to be able to surprise them. You're not going to be able to pull one over on them.
A liar cannot be trusted. We cannot coexist with liars.
My lord? My lord, are you there?
Please welcome our founder, Dr. Ye Wenjie.
Part of the calculation with that last scene was, it's a huge surprise for Jin. It's not necessarily a huge surprise for the audience. Some people will be ahead of it, some people won't.
When you're tasked with having to reveal a bombshell, you want it to land with the audience. So that also includes how you then choose your camera work. Because if you become all like, oh, I'm going to do a big zoom in, I'm going to do this really like clever tricksy shot just before this happens or while this is happening, it kind of detracts from the moment where you as the audience also has to take it in. So it was exciting to find a language for that moment.
And so Jen, who previously felt like this was almost a pseudo-mother character to her, feels instantly betrayed and heartbroken.
We cannot save ourselves. We must prepare the world for their arrival so that they can do with it what we could not. I saw Ye's decision as being a combination of impulsive and logical, because when you've lost everything, I think there is the tendency to be drawn to what you sense as a greater good.
I think filming the entire sequence in the equestrian center was about a week's worth of filming. And we had quite a heavy action sequence with a lot of extras and quite a few stunts. It was a challenge, but a really, really fun one.
Is Ye a good guy or a bad guy? I don't think she's a good guy. I don't think she's a bad guy. I think she's a person who made a tremendous mistake, and that mistake grew from a decision that she knew what was best for the world, that she could make a determination that no one person can ever make.
Yeah, and she had experience with humanity. She had virtually no experience with the Santee, right? So all she knew from them was one message, which says, don't contact us, because if you do, we're going to conquer you. And she chooses to ignore that, or maybe not ignore it, but say, yeah, great, come, I'll help you conquer this world. It's the genius of the books is that it poses this question that you can't, once you read that or in the show see it, hopefully you can't stop thinking about, well, what would I do in that situation?
They are coming. And when they arrive, you'll be so grateful.